Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about our first chapter, hardware and software. Our first chapter, hardware and software. Hardware and software. Hardware refers to all the physical components of a computer. Hardware means all the physical components of a computer. That means hardware means all the physical parts. That means those parts of a computer that we can touch, feel and see. These items are called hardware. For example, CPU, monitor, keyboard, mouse, printer, these all are hardware parts of a computer. Once again, hardware refers to all the physical components of a computer. That means those parts you can see, feel and touch. These items are called hardware items. Then now we will discuss one by one. First one, keyboard. You know, keyboard is an input device. It is used to enter information into the computer. Keyboard is an input device. It is used to enter information into the computer. And another one is mouse. Mouse is an input device, you know, it is used to point at the object on the computer screen. A mouse has two or three buttons, and pressing the mouse button once is called clicking. Pressing the mouse button once is called clicking, and pressing the mouse button twice without giving a gap is called a double clicking. Pressing the mouse button once is called a clicking, normally left click, and pressing the mouse button twice without giving a gap is called a double clicking, and pressing the right mouse button once is called a right clicking. And one more action, drag and drop. And pressing the mouse button by keeping the pointer at the starting point and moving it to a new location and then releasing the mouse button is called a drag and drop. And these are the various actions of a mouse. Once again, clicking means normal left clicking, double clicking, right clicking, and drag and drop. These are the various actions of a mouse. And next to hardware part is CPU. You know, CPU is called the brain of the computer, and CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. It is called the brain of the computer, and it controls all the functioning of the other parts of the computer. And a CPU is divided into two parts. The CPU is divided into two parts. First one, arithmetic and logic unit. Arithmetic and logic unit. A L U. And next one, control unit. Control unit. The CPU is divided into two parts. First one, arithmetic and logic unit. Second one, control unit. The arithmetic and logic unit performs all the arithmetical calculations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and all the logical operations. Listen, the arithmetic and logical unit performs all the arithmetical calculations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and logical operations. The control unit controls all the functioning of the part of a computer. Control unit controls all the functioning of the parts of the computer. CPU is divided into two parts, arithmetic and logic unit ALU and control unit CU. And the next one is memory unit. Memory unit. The memory unit is placed inside the CPU cabinet and it contains all the data, instruction and information that fed through the input devices, and it has two parts. The memory unit is divided into two parts, RAM and ROM. Memory unit is divided into two parts, RAM and ROM. Memory unit is divided into two parts, RAM and ROM. RAM stands for random access memory. RAM stands for random access memory. Random access memory. RAM stands for random access memory. And ROM stands for read only memory. Read only memory. The memory unit is divided into two parts, RAM and ROM. And the next one is monitor. You know, monitor is an output device. Monitor is an output device, and it is also known as visual display unit. A monitor is also known as visual display unit. Visual display unit. VDU. Monitor is an output device, which is also known as visual display unit. The output given by a monitor is called a soft copy. Listen, the output given by a monitor is called a soft copy. Soft copy. Monitor is an output device. It is also called a visual display unit. And another hardware part is printer. Printer is an output device. It is used to print our work on a paper. Printer is used to print our work on a paper. The printout taken from a printer is called a hard copy. The printout taken from a printer is also called a hard copy. Hard copy. Hard copy. And the next one, microphone. Microphone is an input device and it is used to record our voice and sounds. Microphone is an input device and it is used to record our sound and voice. And the next one, speakers. Speakers are output devices. Speakers are output devices and it is used to produce recorded music and sounds. Speakers are used to listen the music or produce the recorded music and sounds. And next one, floppy disk. And you know, floppy disk is a storage device. It is used to store the information permanently. Floppy disk is used to store information permanently. And the next one, CD and DVDs. CDs and DVDs. And CD and DVDs are the storage devices. And CD stands for compact disc. CD stands for compact disc. CD. Full form, compact disc. Disc. And DVD stands for digital versatile disc. DVD. Digital versatile disc. CD and DVDs are circular in shape and have a great storage capacity. And listen, CDs and DVDs have a huge storage capacity. And they can store music, pictures, and movies, etc. CDs and DVDs. And next one is hard disk. Next one, hard disk. Now hard disk is fixed inside the system cabinet, and the hard disk is the storage device with highest storage capacity, and it is fixed inside the system cabinet, and you cannot carry it from one place to another. And hard disk is fixed inside the system cabinet, and it has a huge storage capacity. And next one is pen drive. And pen drive is a small storage device, and it is called a pen drive because we can put it in our pocket like a pen. And a pen drive is a small storage device. It's a small storage device, and we can put in our pocket like a pen. And once again, these are the hardware parts of a computer. Once again, keyboard, mouse, CPU, then monitor, printer, microphone, speakers, then we will discuss CDs, DVDs, pen drive, hard disk, and pen drive and hard disk. Next one, what is meant by software? Software. You know, hardware refers to all the physical component of a computer. Then software means it refers to a set of instructions that perform some task on a computer. Software refers is a set of programs that performs some task on a computer, and we cannot see or touch the software part of the computer. We cannot see or touch the software part of the computer. When we start our computer, the software automatically starts. And some popular software items, examples of some popular softwares are Windows XP, and MS Office, Corel Draw, Tally, Photoshop, WinZip, these are the examples of popular softwares. Software means a set of instructions that performs some specific task on a computer. And examples are Windows XP, MS Office, Corel Draw, Tally, Photoshop, WinZip. These are the examples of popular softwares. And once again, in this chapter, we will discuss the hardware and software part of a computer. Hardware means all the physical component of a computer. That means keyboard, mouse, CPU, then memory units, monitor, printers, microphone, speakers, and then we will discuss some storage devices, also floppy disk, CDs, DVDs, hard disk, and pen drive. Next one, what is meant by software? Software means the set of instructions that performs some specific task on a computer. Okay, thank you.